Howdy, Dr. Will Wong here, and welcome to tonight's edition of the Essentials of Life and Wellness. Let us start with your questions. Let's start with something that's a question wrapped around a testimonial. Hi, Dr. Wong. Again, I want to congratulate you for your products. Zymescent is a wonderful product. It really works. I wanted to let you know how the Zymescent worked for me. Number one, I could not laugh. I had a burning pain underneath my left clavicle. It is now gone. Number two, I had a tendon in my right foot that ached for years. Now it is gone. Three, I fell off my bike and I hurt my left hand. My hand got bluish in color and it throbbed in pain. I could not move the fingers of the hand. I took 10 Zymescents for 3 days. Now it is gone. Number four, the worst of these, I could not drive with both hands on the steering wheel. Every 2 to 3 minutes, I had to change my hand. It was not pain, but I felt a burning in my arms. I also felt my body aching all the time. Now it is gone. The doctors only prescribed anti-inflammatory drugs that did not have good results. Zymescents healed me. Once again, I thank God and you to be put in my way, Dr. Wong. Now, I have a question. I have a doubt about Zymescents and protein. It is not clear to me. Can I eat a steak and some eggs, protein, and hours later take the Zymescents capsules? I'm sorry for my poor English. I hope you understand. Thank you, and God bless you. And my answer is, howdy. Thank you for telling us how well Zymescents has worked for you. All the thanks and glory go to God. An empty stomach or abstaining from protein are not as necessary with the Zymescents as it was with the older and weaker blends of systemic enzymes in the past. The older blends feared that a substantial portion of their enzyme activity would be lost to digestion if taken near food, so that not enough of the enzymes would be available for absorption and body-wide action. With Zymescents, that is not as much the case, as it takes only 1/12 to 1/16 of the enzymatic activity in one Zymescent to digest a Christmas feast. So taking the Zymescents near food, even a steak and eggs, etc., will not result in a loss sufficient enough to impair the systemic, the body-wide action of the enzymes. If possible, try to take Zymescents 30 minutes before or 60 minutes after a meal, but if it is not possible, take it anyway, and don't worry. That these concerns are still an issue and still spoken of show you how weak the other systemic enzyme products are. Be well and God bless, Dr. Wong. I'm sorry, I just had to get that last dig in. We seem to be the product that everyone else compares themselves to. Even the folks who used to be the big boys 20 years ago are comparing themselves to us, or folks are coming up with new products and saying it's just like Zymescents, or it's stronger than Zymescents, it's better than Zymescents. And when push comes to shove, they don't even come close, regardless of what their labels say they have in terms of enzymatic activity. Does it sound like I'm really proud of my Zymescents? You betcha. I fulfilled my promise to myself and made the most potent systemic enzyme available at an affordable price. And I'm very proud that even though we're a very small and niche company, everyone else, the big boys, are trying to compare themselves to us. And here's another testimonial that came in the exact same day from someone else. Hi, Doc. This pat on the back is for you and your enzymes. Our daughter has scleroderma. She got it 8 years ago. And because of your enzymes, plus a good holistic doctor, she is at least 90% well. Her hand that at one time was blue is now healthy pink. She is now working at a job she likes, and her boss is wonderful in allowing her to come in later in the morning. She still has to cough up phlegm in the morning to clear her lungs, but praise the Lord, she is healthy and living a normal life. She has tried to share her story with others who have the problem, but they chose not to listen. It's sad, but that's life today. Thank you. We recommend your enzymes to everyone with a major problem. And my answer is, howdy. Yay, wonderful news. The thanks and praise goes to God. Scleroderma has always been thought to be irreversible, to be incurable. Been telling docs and patients about the use of systemic enzymes against the condition since 1999. A good many dermatologists have listened, but most have not. A good many patients have listened, and as your daughter has discovered, most won't. Speak of it to those who are willing to listen, but don't beat your head against the wall with the folks who won't listen. Through systemic enzymes, God has given scleroderma patients hope. But I stopped talking to the wall years ago, and now I only preach to the choir. On top of the enzymes, make sure your daughter takes 100 milligrams of zinc a day. Zinc is essential for any skin condition, as it is the primary mineral building block for skin. If she chooses to use our zinc citrate, 100 milligrams is one capsule daily. Our best to you and continued good health to your daughter. Be well and God bless. Dr. Wong. And now a question came in as to what systemic enzymes can do for a patient with cystic fibrosis. And my answer is howdy. Most CF patients die in their 30s from fibrosis buildup in the lungs or in the kidneys. They make no proteolytic enzymes and so have no way to lyse away the excess fibrin, the excess scar tissue, the excess fibrosis from their internal organs, and the scar tissue builds, clogs, and kills. With CF patients, we suggest they get on a good systemic enzyme on top of the pancreatin that they're prescribed to take for their digestion. If zymescence is used, 2 to 3 capsules taken in between meals 3 times a day would be a good dose. It won't stop or arrest the cystic fibrosis. That is a genetic condition, and it cannot be reversed. It won't help the patient make any of their own enzymes, but the zymescence will lyse away and eat away the fibrosis that is building up in the hollow organs, and it can extend the lifespan of a CF patient. Be well and God bless, Dr. Wong. And on to the next question. Dear Dr. Wong, I have just purchased your zymescence after hearing about it from Mike Mahler and his radio show with you. Here are my questions. Number one, I have type 1 diabetes for 31 years. I am 41 and in great shape regardless. Would my beta cells still work after the scar tissue is eaten away and the inflammation gone? Question number two, since the enzymes eat fibrin, would this help blood flow to the penis as well if there are small fibrin blockages in the arterial walls of the penis? Number three, nothing to do with enzymes, but how do we increase the sperm thickness and count as we age, meaning it looks clear and like a small drip instead of being like when I was 18 when it was white thick with large amounts? Do you have any ideas about this? And my answer is howdy. Number one, in many cases, type 1 diabetic patients using systemic enzymes have been able to reduce or eliminate their insulin as the enzymes lysed away the fibrosis in their pancreas. While I have caught flack from diabeticians for stating that fibrosis was blocking the channels the beta cells use to get insulin into the blood, a recent university study I spoke of in the past has showed that amyloid deposits indeed cover the beta cells, preventing insulin from getting in the blood. I was proven absolutely right. Amyloid deposits are a form of fibrosis. While not all type 1 patients can drastically lower their insulin need, which shows that sometimes the beta cells do die off if they've been covered over by fibrosis long enough, most type 1 patients do get to lower their insulin intake and have improved A1Cs. Number two, yes, I've spoken to this in podcasts, but to find out what the 4 essentials are for full sexual ability and function, listen to my podcast with Mike Mahler, his podcast number 118 at mikemahler.com. Also, get a copy of my book, Maximum Male Performance, from drwongsessentials.com. Number three, the answer to increasing seminal volume, improving sperm number, motility, and strength, and how this feeds into improved orgasms is all in the book, Maximum Male Performance. Be well and God bless, Dr. Wong. And the next question asks, Dear Dr. Wong, I have a product question. I have been taking zymescence for the past week, about 2 to 3 capsules a day for a case of adhesive encapsulitis, which was confirmed by MRI. My main issue is the pain, especially at night, which seems to be more joint capsule than muscular at this stage. Any advice in regards to taking the supplement and treatment? And my answer is, howdy, not enough. Try 2 capsules 3 times a day in between meals. Add our mag scorbate at 1 capsule 2 times a day to help with any muscular spasm and contracture. Also, frozen shoulders are best treated with a combination of systemic enzymes and myofascial release. And then I sent this person to the John Barnes myofascial release website where they have a link where they could find a therapist close to them. Be well and God bless, Dr. Wong. Whenever you have an issue of range of motion or lack of range of motion or too much fibrosis, impingement of movement by a scar tissue, dry bursar sacs, or whatever may be happening, as in this frozen shoulder, it not only takes the enzymes to work from the inside, but you need to have some outside work to realign fascia to help break up adhesions and scar tissue manually, to stretch them out or to break them up with the hands, and to help to restore proper movement and range of motion from the outside. Can't all be done from the inside. I wish the work could all be done from the inside, but it can't. Of all of the body working techniques from Rolfing to Swedish massage that I have seen, the best at restoring range of motion, the best at getting rid of adhesions, the best at restoring function is John Barnes's myofascial release. And the next question is, Dear Dr. Wong, I'm a 62-year-old female and I'm 60 pounds overweight. I have been this way for 15 years and have tried everything from vegan to paleo diets. I exercise regularly, use weights and sprints. I'm hypothyroid and take both the Natrathroid and the levothyroxine for it, and I have been checked out every 6 months. I have the BioT hormone implants. I am really tired of dragging all this extra fat around since I used to be slim. Thank you for your suggestions. And my answer is, howdy. You've done everything I would have advised a gal in your position to do. The only other alternative that I know of is a medical one with the lipazine injections combined with an appetite suppressant, which is a psychotropic drug, and amphetamines for weight loss. I've seen it work well on gals with your same realm of failures, but be mindful of the side effects. If your family notices changes in personality and or erratic behavior, drop the drugs and the program. I have to say here that you won't notice changes in your behavior or if you're acting erratically, but your family around you will. If you are noticing racing heartbeats and arrhythmia, stop the drugs and the program. If you're a fast metabolizer, the drugs will be out of your system in some 5 days. If you're a slow metabolizer, it will take 25 days. So the personality side effects will last as long as the meds are in your body. Some women do really well on the program, and some get heart valve problems, and some just go nuts. But the program does work. Be well and God bless, Dr. Wong. Now, I have to say that no one should do the lipazine injections along with the appetite-suppressing psychotropic drugs and the amphetamines unless they absolutely can't lose weight any other way. This program is administered by doctors, but I have seen docs not give a frickin' rat's ass about the side effects that patients are having and simply concentrate on how much weight they're losing. Do the docs not know what the side effects are? Do the docs not know that these patients can commit suicide? Do the docs not realize the horrible effects that psychotropics have on the brain and that amphetamines have on the heart valves? But no, most of the docs don't give a rat's ass. They just go through the program and not care whether the patient has side effects. So if you put yourself on the program, if you find one of these MDs and get on that weight loss program, have your family monitor you for the side effects of the drugs. And then you have to be willing to get off the program if you have the side effects. I've known a few women who are so enthused with the weight loss, they don't care that they're going nuts. They don't care that they're thinking of killing themselves, and they don't care that their heart is racing and going into arrhythmia. All they want is a smaller dress size. That's frickin' insane. And the next question asks, my husband takes statins and aspirin after having bypass surgery. I was interested in your products for male sexuality, but was wondering if it was okay for him to use these products while taking the Crestor. Could you let me know if there would be any interference using your products and which products you would recommend for him? And my answer is, howdy. Total cholesterol below 180 makes it so the body does not make any sexual hormones. Most MDs have either forgotten or have never learned this fact. No, there is no conflict between the pro-sexual, pro-testosterone supplements and the anti-cholesterol drugs and the aspirin. here is a link to a show where I explain in detail what is needed for sexual function. And again, I sent this gal to the MikeMahler.com website to listen to podcast number 118. As to supplements, my suggestions are zinc citrate, 100 milligrams daily. If you use ours, that's one capsule daily. Mag scorbate, one capsule two times daily. Synest, two capsules before bed. Andean essence, three capsules two times a day. And arginine ethyl ester with TMG, two capsules two times a day. Be well and God bless, Dr. Wong. Again, remember, folks, for those of you who are new and are wondering why I'm having folks use zinc and magnesium, it is impossible to make testosterone without zinc and magnesium. Those are the two mineral cofactors that are essential for making testosterone. The zinc also is the most abundant mineral in male sexual organs, also in female sexual organs. The uterus is supposed to be zinc rich. Both the prostate and the uterus can get sick with long-term zinc deficiencies. Every ejaculation loses 15 to 30 milligrams of zinc. Well, that's as much as the USRDA says you're supposed to have in a day. What happens when you tally together all of your ejaculations? How much zinc have you lost? Zinc deficiency and vitamin E deficiency, along with high estrogen, are the three primary prerequisites for a swollen prostate. And if you want to know all the things that magnesium does for you, just go online and type in magnesium is essential, and you'll find out why magnesium is so important for you, besides helping to maintain your sexual function and helping to make testosterone. And on to the next question. Dear Dr. Wong, I am 65 and have been recently diagnosed with a fatty liver and have a cyst on it. I donated blood and I found that I had Hep B antibodies in my blood, which led me to pushing my doctor for further tests. My question is, will systemic enzymes help me? And my answer is, howdy. According to Chinese oncologist Dr. Su Sar Chi, all cyst formation is a result of estrogen dominance. So my suggestions are Synest, two capsules before bed. Zymescence, two capsules taken in between meals three times daily. These are from DrWongsEssentials.com. Also, B-complex vitamins, one capsule two times daily. Liver Qi, two to three capsules three times daily. From Qi, Qi-health.com. Or you can use Live 52, three capsules three times daily. From HimalayaUSA.com, HimalayaUSA.com. Be well and God bless, Dr. Wong. The Live 52 and the Liver Qi from Dr. Qi are the two best liver support supplements on the market, bar none, period. There is nothing in the allopathic world, there is no allopathic drug that can match either one of those supplements for what they do and how they help support sick and toxic livers. And the next question. Dr. Wong, I have just ordered your Zymescence, and I have a history of failed temporomandibular joint surgery that's always ended in bony ankylosis or fusion of the jaw joints with dense fibrosis. In the mid-1980s, I was implanted with an artificial temporomandibular joint disc of a material called Vitec Teflon Prolast that caused foreign body giant cell reaction in my joints. The material was recalled by the FDA because of the devastating effect. The tiny particles of PTFE, Teflon, that particulate off of the artificial disc implant caused foreign body giant cell reaction that destroys bone, muscle, and nerve tissue. I've had 11 surgeries now and have two total artificial jaw joints implanted into me. My last CT scan shows there dense radiolunices in the joint and reabsorption of the socket that represent foreign body giant cell reaction, still ravaging my tissues and bones of my jaw joints. There's a massive amount of scar tissue produced in this process, and the body tries to encapsulate these foreign particles in the joints. the materials and the reaction that is going on in my body is with me for life and travels systemically. Do you think Zymescens will be able to eat up the scar tissue and dense fibrosis and reduce the inflammation? This FBGCR reaction causes, so hopefully my jaw joints won't lock up and fuse shut once again. I have extreme facial nerve damage and nerve-related pain as well from the multiple surgeries. I am at 10-plus pain levels every minute of life, and I'm completely disabled from the facial pain. I am currently on multiple pain medications with no success. Recently, I was put on methotrexate and tried to mediate the foreign body immune response. I have no rheumatoid factors. Do you think the Zymescens can be taken with all of my medications and the methotrexate? I was also told to take Natron's Trinity probiotic for 30 days on and 30 days off with the Zymescens. Have you ever heard of this? I see only that Zymescens is taken on its own with and has good effects. Could you tell me what dosing do you think Zymescens should be taken at for my particular situation? Anything else you can tell me on how Zymescens might help my problems or any recommendations would be most appreciated, and I'm looking forward to hearing from you. And my answer is, I am so sorry to hear of your pain and suffering. Yes, I do believe the enzymes can help, but I would not expect miracles or too fast an effect. Yes, the enzymes can be taken with your meds and probiotics. Please read the article that I sent him to drwong.us to read the health article titled The Natural Environment of the Gut. I would suggest that you start off by hitting it with a hammer at 3 Zymescens capsules taken in between meals 3 times a day. Then, as the condition improves, back down the dose of 2 capsules 3 times a day and stay there. If the enzymes manage to lyse away most of the scar tissue, remember the physiological rule that fibrosis, scar tissue, will want to regrow wherever it has already been, so do stay on the enzymes for life. Against the pain, I suggest you try microcurrent electrotherapy, such as the electroacuscope or the Avazia instrument. Search around for an MD, DC, or acupuncturist who might have the instrument and give it a go. The Avazia instrument is very small, can be brought for home use and application. Go to Avazia, AVAZZIA.com. I've got both named instruments, and while both work very well, the Avazia is a lot handier than the 35-pound acuscope. If you do get the Avazia, I would suggest getting the Y-shaped hand wand as it makes application easier. Hope these ideas help. Hope you get relief from your pain. Be well and God bless. Dr. Wong. And on that note, I wish you God's blessings. Be well, and I'll chat with you again next time. Bye-bye.
Thank you for joining Dr. Wong this evening for today's edition of The Essentials of Life and Wellness. If you have any questions about today's show, or if you would like to ask Dr. Wong any other health-related question, you may send an email to radio@drwong.us. That's radio at drwong.us. Or telephone him at 940-325-2147. The products mentioned in today's show, as well as all of the other products Dr. Wong recommends, can be purchased online at docsprefer.com. That's www.docsprefer.com. Or you can speak with a customer service representative at 940-325-2147. Dr. Wong also has an extensive natural health website filled with articles written in Dr. Wong's own unique and easy-to-understand style that discuss natural remedies for some of today's most common and debilitating chronic conditions. You can find these articles at drwong.us. That's www.drwong.us. Until next time, we hope you have a safe and healthy week. Be well, and God bless.